to our good friend and dear sister, Joan Huth, to minister the word of God to us. God bless you, sister.
Thank you. Well, hello again. It's good to be with you today. Thanks for joining us. I'm Joan Huth of Follow His Way Ministry. It's a blessing to be here and to chat with you today. Our message today is Christ within us brings breakthrough. God is goes before us with the breaker anointing. He is the breaker that goes before us. He breaks those barriers down, those things down that would try to keep us from following His will and His way for our lives. I want to read for you, start today by reading Micah 2:13. The one who breaks open will come up before them. They will break out, pass through the gate, and go out by it. Their king will pass before them with the Lord at their head. God is at our head. God goes before us, God is beside us, and God is behind us. This message in Micah was given to the land of Judah by Micah, God's prophet, when they were destined to fall. God was telling them how he would bless them if they would come back to him and follow him with their whole heart. Another prophetic message in Isaiah 45:1-8. Thus says the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have held, to subdue nations before him and loose the armor of kings, to open before him the double doors so the gates will not shut. I will go before you and make the crooked places straight. I will break into pieces the gates of bronze and cut the bars of iron. I will give you the treasures of darkness and hidden riches of secret places, that you may know that I, the Lord, who call you by name, am the God of Israel. God spoke this message to Cyrus, his anointed. Then what will, if he spoke that to Cyrus, what will he do for us who walk within, we walk with Christ within us, the kingdom of God in us? How blessed we are to have Jesus in us. Jesus is our breaker in Christ. We are all waiting for some sort of breakthrough in our lives. How can we activate God's anointing, his breaker anointing in us? As Isaiah 45 tells us, God wants to give us treasures of darkness and hidden riches to break in pieces the gates of iron and to make way straight before us. God holds the enemy back so his promises can flow in our lives. Hallelujah. We, as I said just now, we as God's children carry the kingdom of God before us. Therefore, if we let go and let God, God opens the door of breakthrough before us. It is Christ in us that brings us hope, the hope of glory, God's glory, in and through Christ Jesus, our Redeemer and our Lord. Holy Spirit is our guide. He reveals all wisdom and knowledge to lead us to God's perfect, perfect will. His destiny in our lives is always his perfect way. 1 Corinthians 2:11. For what man knows the things of a man except the spirit of man which is in him? Even so, no one knows the things of God except the Spirit of God. Precious Holy Spirit, I want to stop here a moment just to speak a little about Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is in us. He is Jesus in us. Jesus is at the right hand of the Father. Holy Spirit is our communicator to God. How wonderful that is. Getting to know Holy Spirit on a personal level is getting to know God, is getting to know Jesus. Holy Spirit is the one who communicates God's voice to us, leads us and guides us in everything, in every way. Having communion with God in and through Holy Spirit in Christ Jesus every day brings breakthrough in our lives. Recently, recently I had sort of a revelation on this, and about people are always talking about, I'm waiting for my breakthrough, I'm waiting for my breakthrough. And recently I heard someone give a message on how we carry the breakthrough every day in our lives. And it's like we're waiting on the edge for that breakthrough. But really, we have God's blessings every day, and His will is done in our lives and through our lives. If we just keep our eyes on Him and not focus on those things we do not have, but focus on those things that are such a blessing in our lives and wait on Him. Because we do have seasons in our lives, and those things that we're waiting for, they will come in. But every day is glorious in Christ. Every day is glorious in God. God's thoughts are on God's, God has us in mind, and He wants to bring us through those things that we're waiting to get through. But meanwhile, we can receive His blessings and have His peace and His joy every day, instead of just holding on, saying, I'm waiting for that breakthrough, I'm waiting for that breakthrough. And to me, it was like, I kind of knew that always, but it was like a revelation to me, and that was just recently. So I just praise God for that, and because we should be thankful every day of our lives and have communion with God every day, every day. He loves us so much. We can't even fathom how much He loves us. He loves us that much. We thank You, Father. Let's see where I was here. Okay. Holy Spirit reveals God's plans and purposes for our lives. He is Jesus in us, as I said. Holy Spirit is God's communicator. It's good to repeat that and repeat that. We need to remember that. And He brings us comfort, peace, rest, and hope. Pursuing God will reveal His wisdom. Paul encourages the Colossians with his prayers in chapter 1. And he says, that they may be filled with the knowledge of His will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that they would walk worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing Him, being fruitful in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all might according to His glorious power, for all patience and long-suffering with joy, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to be partakers of His inheritance of the saints. Paul goes on to tell us that God reveals mysteries which have been hidden from ages, from generations. Surrendering our whole heart, seeking God's will in all things. This is really not as difficult as it sounds. If we are only willing, God's grace will guide us if we are just willing. We can't even do that on our own. We need God to help us to be willing. And surrendering our lives to Him on a daily basis, we are supernatural beings, and we just do things supernaturally in His way and in His will, because that's the joy of our heart, to bless Him and have Him look at us and say, well done, good and faithful servant. Thank You, Father. Remember, when we want more of God, our flesh becomes less, and the Spirit of God becomes so much stronger in us. God makes it happen in and through Holy Spirit. Christ in us is the hope of glory. Holy Spirit leads us in our thoughts and desires and draws us nearer to Jesus. 1 Corinthians 1:16. For who has known the mind of the Lord that He may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. Hallelujah. Jesus changes situations to give us favor. He sees how the end result will bring us favor when we cannot see it in the natural. Jesus changes situations for our favor. Hallelujah. In Psalm 5:12, for You, O Lord, will bless the righteous with favor. You will surround him as a shield. I quote this scripture. I try every day, but Holy Spirit reminds me that God wants to give me His favor. I believe it, I speak it, and I receive it. Hallelujah. God goes ahead of us and breaks and tears down whatever might try to hold us back from have our destiny in Him to be fulfilled. God is the one who gives us the desires of our hearts because they are the desires of his heart if we love and want to serve him with our whole heart. Psalm 37, 3-8. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and feed on his faithfulness. Delight yourself also in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. He shall bring forth your righteousness as the light and your justice as the noonday. Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him. Do not fret because of him who prospers in his way, because of the man who brings wicked schemes to pass. Cease from anger and forsake wrath, and do not fret. It only causes harm. And how many times have we experienced that in our lives? But you know, we through our mistakes we learn, and through our mistakes we change, and praise the Lord for that. Just as the scripture tells us, if we delight ourselves in the Lord, he will give us the desires that he has for us because our hearts are one with him. When we are born again, new creatures in Jesus Christ, he is now our Savior, also our Redeemer, and our Lord. Therefore, when we trust in him, rest in him, and wait on him, his desires will become our desires. Proclaiming the word of God is using God's breakthrough anointing, which now resides in us. For Christ in us is the hope of glory. His word never comes back void. Therefore, he will fulfill his promises. As we pursue God in a deeper relationship with him, we will come to know his voice, and his voice we will hear more clearly. Being in his presence will reveal the vision he has for us to pursue in and through Holy Spirit. In Hosea 4:6, the Lord spoke to the priests of Israel, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge." You know, even though this was in the Old Testament, we can still hold this for truth today. For even in our new covenant in Christ Jesus, we as children of God really need to take heed to the scripture. For as we go to Christ, as we go to God in Christ through Holy Spirit, God will reveal his wisdom and vision for our lives. Hallelujah. The word of knowledge here in this scripture, in Hosea, refers to intimate fellowship with God rather than an understanding of who he is. Intimate fellowship with the Father. We thank you, Lord, that you want to have a dialogue with us, Lord. And as we hear your voice, as you hear our voice, you want us to hear your voice, Father. And we thank you for that, Lord. For the redeemed in Christ, this means the same thing. If we do not have intimate fellowship with God through Holy Spirit in Christ Jesus, how can we know the plans and visions for our lives? Wow. You know, let's think about that for a while. But as we go to God in prayer every day or however often you go, we can always hear his voice. He always wants to speak to us. His voice is the peace that we feel, even in our heart, even in our spirit. That's hearing the voice of God. Psalm 33:3. Call to me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. It is the knowledge of the Spirit that brings us true wisdom and not the knowledge of man. My favorite psalm, Psalm 29:11. For I know the thoughts I think of you, toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. Then you will call upon me and go and pray to me, and I will listen to you, and you will seek me and find me when you search for me with all of your heart. Here again, we see how God will hear you if you seek him, searching for him with your whole heart. When God becomes so real to you that you cannot imagine your life without him, then you know your heart is crying out to him the best way it can. I know that all of you have had that feeling at times where you feel you're not praying enough, you're not reading the word enough, you want to get into scripture more. Well, this is no condemnation in Christ Jesus, right? Well, this feeling, beloveds, when you feel this way, you know that you are searching for God with your whole heart, and the Lord just loves it. Thank you, Lord. God knows just what we need and when we need it. He knows our deepest desires, what makes us happy, and the things of the past and present that fill our hearts with despair. He knows our weaknesses and what can bring us joy. And God loves to bring us joy. We thank you, Lord, that the joy of the Lord is our strength, Father, and we can go on each day, each and every day, Lord, knowing that peace and that joy in Christ Jesus. In 2 Chronicles 1, 6 to 12, Solomon went before the Lord to worship, and the Lord appeared to him and said, "Ask, what shall I give to you?" Well, Solomon asked the Lord for wisdom and knowledge to rule over the people. Because he did not ask for riches, honor, or long life, God gave Solomon wisdom and knowledge, but also riches and honor and long life, more than any king before or any king after Solomon's reign. Solomon chose God over the things of the world. Hallelujah. And as we choose God above the things of the world, wow, more and more and more. It says in his word that Jesus came to give us life and to give it to us more abundantly. Now, I believe, yes, that means things to make us more comfortable in our lives, but I believe to give us life more abundantly is to give us more and more Jesus, and just to look to him and not look at the riches of the world. Wow, you know, how much do we need to survive and to go ahead? I have learned this in my life, even as I've been widowed for many years, and God has always taken care of me. And as you grow in the Lord and you get old, you realize, wow, you don't need that much to survive. You can survive on very little, although God likes to give us more. He wants to make our lives comfortable. So I've learned that through the years, and it's just such a blessing to know that and to look back. And if you're in need today, God will provide that need, because he provided the other needs that you needed. So if he did it then, he'll do it today. So hallelujah for that. Thank you, Lord. So I want to say here that Solomon's devotion clearly showed his heart. In Matthew 6:33, where it tells us, "Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you." Hallelujah. Here are a few scriptures that tell us how blessed his children are when they serve him with their whole heart. A couple of scriptures in the Old Testament, but I believe they're worth hearing to encourage us. Joshua 14:9. "So Moses swore on the day, saying, 'Surely the land where your foot has trodden shall be your inheritance and your children's forever, because you have served the Lord wholeheartedly.'" Blessings today are our children's blessings for tomorrow. What we do today affects our children and those who are a part of our lives. We leave an inheritance of who we are in Christ Jesus as a testimony of how we have lived our lives as a child of God. This was Solomon's prayer in 1 Kings 8:23. "Lord God of Israel, there is no God in heaven above or on earth below like you, who keep your covenant and mercy with your servants who walk before you with all of their hearts." Love that expression, serve God with your whole heart. I love that. 2 Chronicles 31, 20 and 21. "Thus Hezekiah did throughout all Judah, and he did what was good and right and true before the Lord his God, and in every work that he began in the service of the house of God, and in the law and in the commandment to seek his God, he did it with his whole heart. So he prospered." So it is, as we seek with our whole heart, that we will have breakthrough in every area of our lives in our daily walk with Jesus, day to day, 24/7. Jesus is our breakthrough. He encourages us to walk with him, for he is our breakthrough in every area, our reward. He is all we need. His grace is sufficient. In James 1, 22-25, the word tells us serving God with our whole heart is being doers of the word and not hearers only, and deceiving yourselves. But if anyone is a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is a man observing his natural face in a mirror, for he observes himself and goes away and immediately forgets what kind of man he was. But he who looks into the perfect law of liberty and continues in it and is not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this one will be blessed in what he does. What can we do in the sight of the Lord by following his commandments, meditating on scripture, and faithfully coming to God in prayer? We can do what is right in the Lord if we do those things. If we seek God the best way we know, then we will be serving him with our whole heart. If there is peace in our hearts, the joy of Jesus in our lives, and a longing to know him more, then this is serving God with our whole heart. God lifts us up when we are weak, even when we feel we do not have the strength to go on one more day. He knows what we're going through and picks us up and carries us through the hard times. He loves us that much. He is our Father and wants us to know how much he cares for us, his beloved child. I want to encourage you today that God will come through for you. God's power through, by, and through Holy Spirit, and not by our own power. When we want to serve God with our whole heart, we can slip into a mode of trying to do it ourselves. I recently went through a time like this, and realized I was losing my peace in the Lord. And I sat with the Lord and meditated on the word and just listened to his, just to feel his presence. And he showed me how that's why I was losing my peace, because it was the spirit of fear that this particular thing was not going to come about. And then I just released it and I surrendered to him, and my peace came back. It was really like immediately. You all know that. I know you've experienced it. It's so wonderful, isn't it? It's absolutely marvelous. We thank you, Father, for that. We thank you, Jesus, for your peace beyond anyone's understanding, oh God. Thank you, Lord. As I was seeking God, even with this message, I think it was around that time, I had a vision in the spirit, and what I saw was a wagon like an old-fashioned wagon, but in the front of it, Jesus had had the front of it, and he was pulling it, and it was Jesus. He didn't look labored. He was just pulling the wagon, and then I happened to see, Jesus kind of stopped and slowed up. And when he did, I noticed that this is all in the spirit, I noticed that there were a couple of spokes missing from the wheel. And then I heard Holy Spirit say, this is what happens to a Christ-filled life that is missing God's direction, not hearing his voice, and not having their eyes focused on the vision for their life. It hampers what could be a smooth ride through life as Jesus is guiding you and directing you. Because of a part of their whole heart for God is missing, a connection to him. In other words, the spokes that were missing showed that this is why Jesus had the labor. But if we had all the spokes in place, how easy it is for Jesus to direct us. So we must have a heart-to-heart connection with the Father. And if we don't, there's always that little piece missing, and it might become a little bit harder for Jesus to direct us because our heart is not fully in attention to him. I thought that was a really neat, that was a long time ago, but I thought that was a really neat vision, and sort of the, you know how the prophetic is, how it explains things in the natural, and so that you can see in a spiritual, supernatural way. Taking one day at a time and one step at a time, and not trying to outwit God, is the best way, I think, to have the peace of Jesus and the peace and contentment of Holy Spirit. Just think, as we thank God for each day, for all he's done, all that he's doing, and all of his blessings that are on the way when we need them, just when we need them. God will be pleased and he will continue to go before us and clear the way for his plans for our lives. Because Jesus is the breaker that brings our breakthrough, the hope of glory that lives within us. He is on our side. He came to bring us life and to bring it more abundantly. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I would like to share with you a prophetic word that I believe was from the Lord. He gave this to me to speak to his people. So we honor you, Lord, with your word, Father. We thank you, Lord, that only your voice will be heard and only your word spoken, Father. And we thank you, Father, that you speak to your children in order to give us encouragement, Lord God, and to guide us, Father. I have made a way that will cover all of your needs, saith the Lord. I am the same yesterday as I was. I am the same today as I was yesterday. I am forever and ever. As you have called out to me, Mayday, Mayday, I have heard you over the waves of hurting that you have gone through, the days of heartaches that you have had, and the years of waiting for that special touch that you need to be adjusting your life so it can be lived with more of my peace. My beloveds, it is not only in my heart to give you what you desire, but you are in my heart to the extent of what I have for you in my vision, my way for your lives. Therefore, it is this day that I call you to seek me with a fervent heart, a heart that is satisfied with knowing me, for I accept you just the way you are, and this, my dear children, is what I will always do. So, be thou my willing ones, and just love me, and do not feel neglected or left out. For as you have me in your lives, I am ever present with you, and, my dear ones, you will know I am with you if you seek me with all of your heart. I have called this day a day of suddenlies, a revealing day to show my mercy and my love for all people. I am the restorer of the breach, the one who changes things, the merciful ones, a redeemer of all his people. I change not. My love is everlasting and everlasting. We thank you, Father, for your encouraging words, Father, to your saints and to all people, Father. We thank you for your love, Lord, that it is abounding, Lord. We thank you for your mercy, Lord. We give you honor and praise today, Father. And Father God, right now, Lord, I speak, Lord, refreshing to your people, Father. I come in agreement, Lord, for the breakthroughs that they're waiting for, Father God. In agreement with you, Father God, in Jesus' name, Lord, I ask that you send your peace, Lord Jesus, to all who are listening, Lord God, to give your peace to all who are weary, Lord, and heavy laden. Thank you, Jesus. We just thank you, Lord, that you call your people to come, Lord Jesus, and you will give them rest, Lord. We praise and we thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are the breakthrough in every area of our lives as we seek you and focus our eyes upon you, Father. We give you honor and glory for what you have done and what you are doing and you're doing for your glory to be seen in our lives as we pursue your will and your way, Father. We thank you, Father God, that you will never leave us or forsake us. Amen and amen and amen. We thank you, Father. We thank you.